exponentially as a result.
See the town and city start here. Both of these characters are going to really benefit from this. Obviously, the low ceiling is going to be very nice for Mewtwo's up smash. And of course, Corrin, if forced into a situation having to use those throws, it's going to be a little bit easier to take Mewtwo off the top.
Furthermore, of course, those platforms helping out with the ledge cancels from that teleport, allowing Mewtwo to have a greater range of landing options as well. And against a character like Corrin, that is so, so important. She is so good at sharking under characters.
A bit of a scary moment there, but of course Mewtwo with those excellent evasive options. Great placement there with the Town Tilt. Such a great tool for Corrin. Everyone overreacts to how the use is dependent on everything else, but really Down Tilt, one of the strongest tools.
Very, very quick move leads into a bunch of her other tools. It can be punished if you're aware of her doing it, but it's definitely hard to react to.
See Abba continuing trying to make up this deficit.
Great shield drop up air from Cosmos. He, as well as Void, are two of the players that are most proficient with those shield drops, those platform shield drops.
Need a little bit of charge in that Shadow Ball.
Doesn't get the tip of pin, instead he gets stuck by the pin. Great phase fair coming out from Abadango. Sour up tilt into up smash, not quite enough just yet, even on the town and city ceiling.
Just outside of the range of that side here too. Corrin gonna go with the back footer just for percentage and position at this point. Dangerously close, what a great tech. We saw him going for that low up air, but Mewtwo able to use the spacing on that down air to interact with the hit instead.
And this Mewtwo air dodge coming in absolute clutch for Abadango, and he's able to take the first stock after punishing that Dragon Fang shot. Just inches off of that pin. I really feel like that's the way that Cosmos is going to take this first stock from Abadango.
I like Abba with the attempt at that cheeky little early kill. Trying to use that drag down there. Corrin with a little bit of a linear recovery. And now Mewtwo with able to just really punish her.
Finally, the back air making its mark, taking that first stock from Mewtwo. Only 29% on Cosmos. He can definitely build this up quickly if he gets the right hits.
Absolutely. Looking for a dare, looking for that quick pin. Corrin with the ability to just rack on so much damage.
But this Shadow Ball is really, really controlling the mid range. It's not really allowing Cosmos to generate those whiff punish opportunities that he needs to in order to really get his offense started.
Pretty difficult. Corrin, obviously, with the movement speed nerf after her release, and just where the position of the pin puts it as well. I mean, Abba can really abuse the trajectory of the Shadow Ball. Nair on the front of the shield, but that last hit just barely crossing up. Point blank range on that full charge, and now Corrin's shield looking awfully small. Cosmos will be very careful. Just considering we're not even just worried about the shield break, coming in and potentially getting the shield stab with a Nair into a footstool.
Yes.
Very risky situation.
He's not dying to a back air at 66. No way. That said though, Abba does need to be careful. Cosmos has closed the gap spectacularly here. Just a couple of right plays. One solid instant pin in the right position will take Abadango stock. Yeah. And I know that Cosmos is going to be looking most likely for that short hop air dodge. Bad Shadow Ball coming on stage, and Cosmos taking that game. Even after Abadango seemed like he had so much control throughout that game, Cosmos was able to snatch the rug from underneath him.
That's the grim reality of being tied at even percents, or at high percents with Corrin like that, is that as Mewtwo, you're going to have a couple of situations where you can lead into a kill, whereas Corrin really has a very open toolkit. We saw the backer, you talked about the pin, so many options for Corrin to close out stocks at those percentages against Mewtwo. See the switch here to Smashville, going to the other Animal Crossing stage, see how this platform interacts in these smaller, shorter sides for Abadango.
Cosmos off to a strong start at the moment.
I'd be a little bit worried about these edges though, just considering how well Corrin can kill off the sides. I feel like this may actually come back to hurt Abadango here, especially how the first two stocks went. Instapin, always such a dangerous tool, and Mewtwo such a big body coming back to the stage like that. Off in the distance like that, they'll close out stocks so early.
Wow, Instapin just tearing right through that Shadow Ball.
Love the positioning there. Using the back air as more of a movement option rather than a dangerous hitbox. Excellent spacing on that Nair as well.
That's the footstool disable that we know and love from Abadango so much. And he nails it right there to take that first stock.
And that's not an easy move to hit. A lot of Mewtwo mains will struggle with that. You don't see it as often with players outside of ABBA. And he comes in and just executes it so perfectly.
This is very dangerous. Huge position.
Oh my god, the magnet save there.
Impeccable spacing to the ledge right there. He knew the distance that he had, and he made sure to make the most of it.
Instant fair there from ABBA. And building on such a lead now against Cosmos. Potentially going to close this out as a 2-stock if he keeps this up.
Cosmos popping out of the nair that time. 94% on Corrin. This is quite a scary situation. And there it is!
2 for 2 on those. And it's really important to realize just how positional that setup is. You have to land that nair basically coming off the side over the shoulder of the opponent. And it's only after then that it will lead into the footstool instead of knocking them away. ABBA so proficient at it.
Yes, yes, definitely. Very, very practiced, very defensive yet stylish when he needs to be Mewtwo. Optimized in his punish game. Quite a different sort of, definitely a very different sort of Mewtwo to the ones that we've been seeing more recently. Of course, Wadi having an incredibly strong season last season, and SDX, of course, up on the come up as well.
Absolutely. Blowing up from upstate New York right now. And we see Cosmos opt for FD right now. Obviously, a really strong counter against Corrin, using that horizontal control space that Corrin is able to do. It really prevents ABBA from a lot of the movement options that we were seeing.
That said, though, this is a lot of flat open space for Mewtwo to run away and charge that Shadow Ball. So Cosmos is definitely going to need to close the gaps and prevent that from happening in certain situations.
And of course, that charged up smash knows no comparison. Able to use that with such a high... Wow, excuse me, the Abadango getting out of a very dangerous situation.
Ooh, ballsy down there, but it pays off for him, able to get back to the ground.
Been a very nuanced set for both players so far. Neither one really building too much of momentum. And even now, these dead even percents too.
Shadow Ball on Abadango fully charged. He lets it rip and it hits its mark. Almost taking Cosmos to stock. Just off that down air, pinned off the ledge. Is it going to happen? No, good patience from Cosmos. A lot of people like to preemptively act versus that Shadow Ball, but for the most part, it doesn't hit most characters below the ledge. So you can stay there and wait for Mewtwo to fire it off.
That's mostly those going to be sitting right above it with an unfortunate leg grab animation. Corrin obviously not being one of them. Cosmos well aware. Now that pin allowing him to control center stage.
Now Cosmos has to be careful here. He's nearing that up throw. Death percent.
And that's what you talked about at the start of this set. The speed of Mewtwo. They're able to chase down Corrin after those whiff side Bs. It's absolutely critical getting those percents, because look how high Corrin was at 140, 150, and 4-inch Corrin against a very low Mewtwo is a scary, scary thing.
I'm loving Abadango's recoveries. He's choosing a lot of higher angles with the teleport to avoid Cosmos' potential punishes. Up throw from Corrin, enough to take the stock.
19-0, dead even once again. It's been a completely even set so far. No real matchup, or excuse me, no real momentum swings a while in either direction. ABBA coming back with that air dodge into the fair. So low to the ground with that. Really allows Mewtwo to stretch out and really create a lot of havoc in this close quarters combat.
Excellent full hop pin coming out from Cosmos. He has forced Abadango into the corner. That said though, Mewtwo is a character that can thrive pretty well off in the corner due to that Shadow Ball.
You don't want to give a character like that too much space when you get that great projectile charge going.
Right, great cool out on the phase this time. Cosmos is doing a better job now, going for these grabs, going for these delayed aerials, anticipating Abadango's options in neutral.
Of course, Cosmos, every time Abadango comes back to the stage of these very, very aggressive options, has yet to hit their mark, but you have to know it's been waiting. That one moment where he's going to get that read absolutely right and just end this white YouTube stop so early.
Yes. One solid instant hit in the right position can definitely be the stock for Cosmos.
And again from center, not going to be enough to do it, but once again, Abba's going to have to get past the fury of Cosmos.
Up air, even with a good DI, it is enough, and this is a 2-1 lead for Cosmos at the moment.
really seems that every time he loses a stop, loses a game, Abadongo with his pained expression as he rolls back and then comes back just completely neutral-faced. Really just resets himself between each game and realizes that everyone is another opportunity for him to potentially close this out against Cosmos, having to win back-to-back games on Cosmos' counterpicks now.
See Abadongo leaning forward, engaged fully with the game, legs crossed, and ready to try to make this a game five set.
Wow, downer into the pin. Such a creative combo off the rising platform there. The same slow, methodical start that we've seen throughout this set so far. Neither player really opening up too much of a lead from the start.
Interesting for Abadongo to go for the up air in that situation instead of something like a up throw, sorry, instead of something like a forward throw for maybe a little bit more damage. Maybe he just wants to force Cosmos onto the platform and start applying pressure.
Cosmos without any fear landing with an air, eating that shadow ball. Now, of course, now we're very close to having the full thing again. So much shield damage just off of a simple projectile.
What a catch on that confusion in the air, killing Mewtwo as low as 68%!
And we've seen quite a bit of that from Abba, where he'll go for that high recovery, getting above and outside of the range of Corrin, but of course Town and City allowing Cosmos to get up there high enough and ending that stock so, so early. This is his late game conditioning that you expect from either side of these players. Forced to really try to close this gap before too much damage is placed on him. Abba with a really rough situation.
Excellent forward air though coming out from Abba. Almost catches the landing trap with that. Trying to catch the shield with the grab as well. Up throw won't be quite enough to take the stock just yet. He'll need a little bit more percent or a little bit more rage in order to get that kill. Now should be enough.
You see Abba start to look for it a little bit more. These pivot backs. Doesn't want to do anything heavy committal with his movement and allow him to miss a punish. As this percentage start to build, as a defensive player, as Cosmos can be with a lead, this is a really tough situation for Abba to deal with.
Yes, and these back airs continuously clipping Abadongo. He is now sitting at death percent to a Corrin instapin, but finally getting rid of that stock with that up throw.
Absolutely. And we see the game plan go into motion again. Abba tries to retreat to the corner, get that Shadow Ball charge. Cosmos one step ahead now, really, really turning on the game pressure.
Fantastic grab coming out from Cosmos.
Reliable pin kick now going to give him center as well. Just a great tool for Corrin. Even in moments where it is on block, you can actually just retreat back and still maintain a positional advantage.
No punish on that instant pin and the immediate pin. Getting the sweet spot rather than the pin and taking the set. 3-1 Cosmos advancing forward to the winner's side of top 8.
This gives us a quarter of our top 8 already set for you today. Cosmos advancing in a 3-1 set there. Going to be moving on to the bottom half of our bracket at this point. Going to be Liquid MVG Salem versus Gravity to Buzz. It's going to be interesting to see how this goes. Spoke with the Buzz before this set began. They have not played this season, and they were trading sets, I believe, before this too. So this should be, this could go either way.
Yeah, absolutely. Both these players, absolute top caliber players, comfortable top 10 in the world previously.
Oh, easily.
Obviously, in the previous PGR, they were both top 5 as well. So. It'll definitely be interesting to see how this set goes. It can very easily tip in either one's favor.